Welcome, SpinTV fans. It's the Disc Golf World Tour. We're at stop number four at my favorite course of the entire world, Jarva DiscGolfPark, just outside of Stockholm, Sweden. I'm Jamie Thomas, the voice of SpinTV. Happy to be back with you guys. A beautiful summer weekend in Scandinavia. And we have a star-studded lead card for you. Two of these guys have set course records. Of course, KJ's 10-down was then bested by Eagle's 11-down. But three of these guys have been on the lead card in every single World Tour event they've played so far. Talking, of course, about McBeth, Wysocki, and KJ. Ricky is on the lead card of two of the three events. Nate Sexton replaced him for Kono Piste while Ricky was capturing a win at the KC Wide Open. And he's having an incredible season. I really can't wait to see, at the end of the season, kind of look back and reflect and see where it stacks among the best seasons of all time.
Representing Team Latitude 64 and USA, Ricky Wysocki.
I can tell you that I have never seen anybody putt from outside of the circle as well as Ricky Wysocki is this year. See how that comes into play today on a very challenging course. Starts off with a little low line drive, but nice and center fairway. No problem there.
And USA, Eagle McMahon.
Of course, they're playing today is the Major 18 layout at Jarva. It's normally a 27-hole course, and this area they're teeing from is the driving range. Let's see. Couple of guys or gals out there warming up normally any other weekend. Eagle. His first drive of the round, Heiser's out just a little bit. He's in front of that tree though, which is really the only problem to the left. You just want to be in front of that lone tree. The problem is right. You don't want to be too far right on this hole, just because of the shape of the fairway. Here's KJ. And that's drifting right towards the trouble zone.
Representing Team Innova and USA.
I have to wait and see how that kicked. And the world number one, Paul McBeth. Might not be that way for too much longer if Ricky keeps coming on the way he has. A rivalry has taken a step up this year for all of our benefit. Honestly, it's just fun to watch these guys go to work. Paul opting for the roller. That's typically the shot he plays out here. You can see why. It's a big, aggressive shot. As the hole kind of goes, it plays on two levels. You have to get down that embankment that Paul is sitting on the side of. Here's Ricky hauling off on one of them. Landing a little bit right. He should be okay. It'd be tough to birdie, but par's not out of the question. That's a pretty good escape shot there. See what the young gun from Colorado can do. Second shot. That. Wow. That is a big hyzer. From as far back as he was near that lone tree in the fairway to get to the mouth of the green. Paul's in the best position of the four on this hole. Overstable driver, give him a skip. Little low. Little low, little short for McBeth on that. KJ asking for it to come out. It somehow cut through all of those trees. And that's going to be a prayer for a par, but the gap isn't as wicked as it could be. Ricky's going to flirt with the left side. Easily within his range. That should result in a par for Eagle. He talked about embracing the nerves in an interview with UltiWorld this week. Trying to go toe-to-toe against these veterans of all kinds of tours. Old tours, new tours. Paul McBeth, he makes putts on all of them. It's a good start. Ricky with a big par save putt right there. Eagle's gonna clean up his par. KJ's gonna drop one early in the round. Scores are still close. Too close to call. Moving on to hole two. 100 meter little uphill, tricky touch shot. The green is on a slope. This hole for the third round, playing right about par.
Forehand, uphill, flexing at the basket.
I have to be honest, I forgot what I was going to say. That was a very accurate forehand by Paul. Ricky says, let me show you how to do that. It's going to be a little bit short, though. You wonder if Ricky sometimes sets up those longer putts. Eagle's going to opt for that as well. Touch the top of that tree. As you can see, that to get up on the flat spot by the green, you need a lot more power than that 100 meters would suggest. These guys are pulling out distance drivers to throw 300 feet.
Yes!
And there's a kick. That was heading left towards the gallery on that hyzer. Just another example there from Eagle's putt on how that elevation can make all the difference out here. And he's two down through two. Ricky will match him. Putt wasn't quite as far as I thought it was. And Eagle left out of the star frame there. Paul and KJ gain a stroke. Ricky's gonna maintain his two-stroke lead over Eagle. Add to it, actually. Let's go on to hole three. Tricky out of bounds. You need it to fade off right. But you need it to have the height over those trees. See, that white stake is not very far, but Paul's on the dance floor. Another sidearm from Ricky, leaving it a little bit wide. And he's going to find the OB and not have a very good mark. He wants to try to save that par.
Come on!
KJ going back to the backhand Annie. If he had a signature shot, I think that would be it. His his Annie play with his shorter discs is really phenomenal to watch. Here's a little roll from McMahon. Says, I'm going to take some strokes back, Rick. Beautiful upshot there. Should be a tap-in bogey for Ricky. And Paul is coming on strong. Three down through three holes. Little strong side miss from KJ, and Eagle will clean up his birdie. Pair of twos, three and a four from the lead card. We're moving on to what's probably the easiest par four, in fact, statistically, thanks to the metric system I'm looking at right here, is the easiest par four on this front nine. She called it dog leg right. It's more like a right turn going up that hill you can see down in the distance. And this is all about positioning your drive. You want to be close to the gap. The right-handed player's advantage here is fading away so that the angle isn't quite as sharp. As that fairway will narrow down towards the basket. Eagle played an excellent drive there, despite having the least experience on this course of any of the four players. KJ looks to be executing to perfection as well. Let's see what Ricky goes for here. Let's stay with the backhand. Something to note here. See, all four of these guys threw it higher. Despite a downhill play, they kept their disc elevated so they wouldn't challenge that right side and be locked out of the gap. Ricky gets a little speedy on his. We'll have a contested putt for a birdie. Looks like Eagle will have a similar putt on a different side of the green. Nobody really executing the second shot well yet. Let's see what KJ can do. Oh, that's beautiful. Four for four. What can you say? Comes down to a putting battle between Paul and Ricky, then I don't even know who I could put my money on right now. Eagle says, hey, count me in that one too, guys. These guys are just making this look easy. For the record, these putts are not as easy as these guys are making them look.
Go down.
Wow. Star frame. Very nice by the lead card. Now we're going to move on to the kidney. Named because of the shape of the green. It's a little bit upraised, this island. You have to have your distance control dialed on this hole.
Come on, sit down.
Paul does not like what he did there. Into the gallery. Juiced his throw a little bit. Ooh. Beautiful speed control with the putter there by Eagle. Here's KJ, who... This is not uncommon for him to take a forehand on this route. I remember him doing this in 2014 as well. And that's the danger. The line looked really nice. It's a very aggressive play, though.
Ricky forehand putter.
And he almost got saved by the ledge. And this is one of those moments where you wonder if sometimes inexperience isn't a bad thing. Woo! Not for that putt, though. Paul continues to put on a putting clinic. KJ will be able to clean that up for a 4P. Oh, just a little splash by Ricky. We're only five holes in, and this is already a shootout with the putter. I don't know about any of you guys back at home, but whenever I want to improve on something in my game, I love watching the way pros do something, see how they think about it, how they execute it. Rewind this tape. Putting exhibition, that best in the game right here. Let's go on to hole six. 140 meters with this mound green. The basket sits on the back side. Very tough if you're short. Most of these guys are going to want to try to get to the side of it, but with the choke point early in the fairway, that makes that a tall order, as Eagle's going to find out here. A little bit of a drift, but not quite enough for Paul. Challenge in the gallery right there. Yep. And KJ. Very forgiving brush with the trees. And the door's open for Ricky here. If he can put something on this drive. And he's going to go roller. This I have not seen on this hole from Ricky before. And it's a solid drive. Grass is just a little bit thick. Preferred side of the green on the layup for Eagle. Putting into the side of that hill. Ricky. Literally. Dagger. Into the heart of the basket. Just a little bit underneath where the chains are. You can see, guys, we're testing out a new feature on our SpinTV tournament coverage. We're going to select specific points to tell you what disc the guys are throwing. Hope you guys like it. A little addition for you. Nice par save by Eagle right there. This is just one of those holes that a two will gain you not only the stroke over your competitors, but a lot of momentum, getting a big boost, especially going into hole seven. When you look at the way this hole right off the tee, very narrow, 223 feet, this is one of the shortest, if not the shortest, holes on this entire course, and it's daunting. See Paul here going with his XT Nova. Just just grabs the ground and stays right there, giving him a putt. Ooh. KJ knew out of his hand. That was bad. Even the best in the world couldn't get tripped up by some of the tighter holes out there. There's a beautifully weighted approach by KJ. The way Eagle lined up, it looked like he was going for it. A little slip out of the hand. And that's within Ricky's range. Let's see what he does with it. Wouldn't that have been a sight? Paul's going to grab a stroke on the rest of the card. Says thank you very much. The other three will clean up their pars. And we're moving on to hole 8. And this may be my favorite hole on the entire course. It's an expertly sculpted dogleg right. 705-foot par 4. If you watched our round 1 coverage with the feature card, Paul laid a nice drive down there on the day 1. It's looking pretty good, a little bit short of where he was the other day. There's Eagle with a D-line FD. You read that right.
Going red roller, super flippy.
He loves the roller. And he can get massive distance with that. Sometimes a little too much.
KJ. Floating a little bit left, skipping left.
KJ hyzers out. That's the danger on this hole. Long like Eagle or left like KJ, and you'll find yourself OB trying to turn that corner. Ricky's going to go with the roller again. And it's very interesting. That may have not been the best execution, but it's really good to see Ricky expanding his game. 3, 4, 5 years ago, he's a primarily forehand player. He's really worked to get all the shots in the bag. Rollers, forehands, backhands, and I mean, you can see what he's doing now as a result of the effort to diversify his shot selection. As KJ pitches up, I'll have a tester to save par. And McBeth lining up the forehand here. Skip to state inbounds. It does so. Double skip, probably not what he's looking for. Eagle showing a little bit of his inexperience on this course. You're trying to think when you see Ricky line up these forehands. He goes about it the opposite way from most of these pros. Most of these guys are going to throw backhands for their backhands for their aggressive shots, excuse me, and forehands when they have to.
Come on, get left.
Paul missing that shot by just a little bit. And yeah, Ricky, he does the opposite. He's not afraid to go really... Oh my goodness. KJ thought he had it, went to pick up his mini. Says, that's just not fair. Thank you. eagle. Getting bit a little bit on this hole. Ricky has no problem with the putter. Paul's going to clean his par up. It's a close match now. As these two guys are going to tap in. Both taking numbers a little bit higher than they would like to. It's going to be a double bogey for eagle. Bogeys for Ricky and KJ, and a par for Paul McBeth. Grip Equipment, official sponsor of the Disc Golf World Tour this year. Thanks for everything they're doing. Got a chance to check out their Tour Series bag at the La Mirada event. And very nice. I like the black and yellow color scheme that the World Tour has. Paul needed that to get right. Did not. This is a KJ special if I've ever seen it. This hole was built for him. And he, just slips through. Like I said, it was built for him. It gives him a little love. Ricky putting a little turn on that, just watching it glide out nicely. That's a big shot on this hole. Ricky with three bogeys in his first eight holes. A little uncharacteristic. Eagle's going to play the safe layup. All three of the other guys taking very aggressive lines. And the rookie going to go forehand. Set himself up to look. Got a birdie on the second of three par fours in a row, right in the smack dab middle of the course. Here's Paul, strong follow through on that. Should have a very calm, almost no wind by the basket, despite the leaves moving closer to where the players are throwing from. Calm putts are the easiest putts. And look at that little back spin chip and roll. I guess it's got to be forward spin because it rolled forward before somebody calls me out in the comments there. And Ricky just going to stop it on a dime. One down. Two down. I think he's got this. Yep. Three and four. It's always nice when the lead card finishes a video with a star frame. I already can't wait to see what happens in the back nine. But going there, we've got Paul McBeth as your new leader with only nine to play. One stroke on eagle, two on Ricky. A handful on KJ. We're at Jarva Disc Golf Park, guys. Stay tuned for the back nine. I have a feeling this is only going to get better until the end. Until then, I'm Jamie Thomas. You're watching the Disc Golf World Tour on Spin TV.